Presbyta Dickan Yakin. Congo, the whole of the Francophone-speaking countries. This is a man, he is spreading the gospel like fire in West Africa. Francophone countries plus Angola down there. He is the man who has more than 300 churches. Kenya has 300, he has more than 400 churches that he's overseeing. Out of listening and the patience of listening to Apostle God. Mm-hmm. God bless you.
Mm-hmm. Before I speak, we want to call upon the pastor from Guyana.
Thank you very much, Bishop. I do not think that I will do myself justice, my family, and Guyana justice, and the apostle and his family, Mama Das, John Das, Pastor John Das, and his family, Rosman, and the children, if I do not take this opportunity. And Mama Das, thank you for giving me this opportunity. I am very cognizant and respectful that Guyana has been represented, but I would like to compliment that representation by saying that the apostle was not just one of the workers. He laid the foundations from 1961 for what is now called Full Gospel Fellowship. I'm struggling to rectify the records so that it will be recorded that he was not just another laborer. He was not just another worker. I am among the first ones. I would just like to ask the gentlemen and ladies from the current team, especially who are here from Guyana, would you please stand?
Oh, wow.
And they have traveled from London, from Canada, and many parts of the United States to be here on this occasion to celebrate the life and the works and the ministry of Apostle Das and Mama Das. Thank you. My wife has the microphone. She wants to emphasize that we are his first fruits. And we are not. For which we are very proud. And we did not wait until this day to say those words. We were here. We were here in Newport News, in his office, in tears, to let him know that everything that we have become in our lives, he has affected our lives, our families, and this was not Christians who were being recycled. He went into Hindu villages and proclaimed the gospel.
Yes.
And brought converts into the kingdom of God. little bit on YouTube. He was teaching on the heart of Puck. Some of you don't even know what's that. It's a little comic strip that had a tremendous message. And my wife, in tears, said to me, "Do you know that everything we know, this gentleman taught us? Everything we know for these 51 years, what we have been, what we have produced, because we who are here have not just only become converts, like one of the Dasis said, and he was a typical Das. If you know the Dasis, he was a typical Das of the way he gave the harangue of his tribute. That he did not only touch our lives and make us converts. Through our lives, many other churches were born. And now, many nations have been touched by the gospel of Jesus Christ." I remember him the first night I saw him in my village in September 1963. I was just a teenager. And I told my church last Sunday that this was a good-looking, handsome young man, and I need to be careful in these days when you say that, had a tremendous charisma. And in my book also, he must be the best evangelist Guyana has ever produced. I must recognize another evangelist in our midst, Bishop Sam Ramphal, who has also made a tremendous impact as an evangelist whom we love and respect from the current team. Very good. I must honor you here as well. We cannot make that statement without you have made a tremendous contribution as an evangelist. For 5 nights, I heard him preach. We were heckling the meetings, myself and two other friends. And on the sixth night, one of my friends said, "Let us go up closer to see what's going on." And we went up as young men, giggling and frivolous. And I remember him walking around and saying, "Young men, will you be a little serious for a few moments?" I remember that. And we prayed. I repeated a few words. I don't even remember all the words I said. But that night, the Lord Jesus met me and changed my life. I remember him coming to my house about 11 o'clock in the night. We joke about it, a young man who grew up under him, that he was a night owl. He never begins the day at 8 o'clock. He always begins the day at 11 or 12. Of course, he prays through before he begins the day. He wouldn't talk to anybody unless he talks to the master first. I remember him after a crusade meeting. He came to my house. My sister and I begged him, implored him to come and speak to my Hindu father. He said very little. Two other brothers that he brought talked with my dad, old time stories and that kind of stuff. And the apostle prayed that night. The next night, my dad went to the crusade and received Jesus Christ. Amen. How can you not give tribute and honor to an apostle of this caliber? I wrote in my book, where I honor him greatly, the first book I have published. I remember him teaching, and I'll close with this one moment. I remember him, and we joked about it. He started a training program, and he always wanted to do visual, so he wrote on the chalkboard, the call of God, the will of God, the call of God, and marriage is at the bottom. So, the good news or the bad news is, he never reached marriage. By the time you finish talking about the call of God and the will of God, you can't even think about getting married. Because he, every other thing was of so much significance and importance that you don't even want to look at the girl, and the girl don't want to look at the guy. I suppose that's why he took so long to get married also. Because for him, every other thing was prominent and preeminent than the call of God and ministry. His influence on our lives will go beyond time, will go to eternity. We honor him. We love him. My family love him. And Mama Das, my wife and I want to renew our commitment to you, Pastor John Das, and the Das family. We want to renew our commitment. I don't want to make an excuse, but you must also be happy that we are very much involved in the work of God, and it's because of his influence, his DNA, that he passed on to us. But we are also burning the trail for the kingdom of God. But we want to renew this commitment, that we are here to serve and to be alongside. God bless you.
We thank God for our brother from Guyana. Thank you for those words of encouragement and words that are deeper than we could think. Very briefly, let the man who is handling DRC Congo briefly tell you what is going on in the Congo.
Because of the limited time that we have, and the English is not our first language, I speak very slowly and very clearly. But I want just to say, first of all, that we thank God for Apostle Haridas when he had the calling from God that he should leave America and go to Africa. And he had no money. He had to sacrifice all the things that pertained to his family. Sold his house, sold his car, sold everything, and took his wife. And we thank God also that because the wife did not resist the calling, and their child also did not manifest like he should not go, because we know how children are so free in America. When they say something, parents must look at them. And they came all together to Africa, not knowing that the seed that they will plant in Africa, where they came, with a spirit of sacrifice, that seed will produce many, 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 many other children of God and servants of God that will take over the vision that God gave this man of God, his wife and the entire family, to carry on. And I love God for his faithfulness to those who obey him. As my brother said, I will not come back to that, but he went through opposition, but he stood on the ground of what he was doing was in the will of God. And he was on the right place, and he was at the right time. Those are the three major things that he used to teach us, even in Congo and many other nations where Apostle is teaching about the will of God. Be in the will of God, in the right time, at the right place. So we thank God. It is there, at that right place in Kenya, that God miraculously has to take me and bring me there. And from there, God changed all my life and my destiny to put me into His own destiny. And from there, fire has gone in the nations that I am representing today. The French-speaking countries in Africa. We have for the work that Apostle Harry does have been there, we have 8 nations of Africa speaking French. They don't know English. And let me tell you one thing, you people who are speaking English. You have the privilege and no excuse before God.
Mm-hmm.
Because let me tell you, in the matter of evangelism or the Bible, the gospel, English speaking people have the privilege because you have the best Bible. I have gone through all the Bibles that are written in French. Some of them don't even read them because they are totally different from what is the original text.
Mm-hmm.
I am learning Hebrews so that I can go even into the Hebrew Bible. I see a lot of mistakes. If I see a mistake in English Bible, in Hebrew, for instance, for one mistake, in French the same will be multiplied by 10 mistakes. So you can understand when you read only the French Bible, how your mind will be. You will not understand very well what is the real message of the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
That is why, in the whole nations of the world, the most backward spiritually, when we talk about Christianity, is the French speaking people.
Mm-hmm.
It is very sad. And it is now when God took me to Kenya, not knowing any word of English. Himself taught me English. And then I met him, this man of God, and this family, Mama Das, has been a mother for us. For a long time. For all these nations. DRC Congo. Angola. Angola, they speak Portuguese. But many of their people, because of the history, came from Congo.
Mm.
Kinshasa or Congo Brazzaville, where we speak French, so we can communicate with them. Even when we are going there with the apostle, we can talk to some people in French. Those who know it, they will translate in Portuguese and so on. So that is how the gospel has gone, the pure gospel which the apostles brought to Angola, a pure one. It made people to say, we need this man. In DRC, in Congo Brazzaville, in Burundi, in Ivory Coast, in Togo, Cameroon, we call Apostle Hadidas, we call him Koko Das. What is Koko? Koko in Lingala, which is the national language in DRC, means grandfather. And when they call him grandfather, many people will not understand why. It is more than an apostle. Because they say a grandfather is more wise than the father, more merciful than the father, more caring than the father, and more understanding than the father. That is why they